Reduced-dose vaccines protect patients with HIV against Mpox. The smallpox vaccine effectively induces immunity against Mpox virus infection, formerly simian smallpox, in patients with human immunodeficiency virus, HIV, infection, although patients with lymphocyte counts below 500 cells/mm3 require booster doses. According to data from a study published in the Journal of Medical Virology, the data come from the prospective observational study conducted by researchers at the Infection Biology Laboratory of the Department of Medicine and Life Sciences at Pompeu Fabra University and the HIV Unit of the Hospital del Mar Medical Research Institute in Barcelona, Spain. The investigators analyzed T-cell responses induced by vaccination with JYNNEOS. Despite the substantial decrease in the reporting frequency of Mpox cases from the global peak in August 2022, 30,894 cases, to 804 monthly cases in the last 6 months of 2023, Mpox continues to circulate, and there is no specific vaccine. The JYNNEOS vaccine, with protective cross-reactivity against orthopox viruses, is approved by the U.S. Food and Drug Administration and the European Medicines Agency for the prevention of smallpox and pox in adults at high risk for infection. During the 2022 outbreak in the United States and Europe, vaccine shortages led to the emergency use authorization of a lower intradermal dose. This strategy was aimed at increasing vaccine supply up to fivefold. Further clinical trials are needed to evaluate responses to JYNNEOS vaccination and compare different administration routes in patients with HIV infection. Protecting this population against Mpox is a priority because people with high viral loads or low CD4 T lymphocyte counts are especially susceptible to severe disease. Vaccination responses. The study assessed the immune response to the JYNNEOS vaccine in patients with HIV who were receiving antiretroviral therapy as outpatients at the Infectious Diseases Unit of Hospital del Mar in Barcelona, Spain. Participants had viral loads controlled by antiretroviral therapy and CD4 T lymphocyte counts less than or equal to 500/mm3, low CD4 group, or greater than or equal to 500/mm3, high CD4 group, in blood. Vaccine responses were compared with those of vaccinated controls without the disease. The study included cases that received the standard subcutaneous vaccine before August 2022, or the emergency dose-saving intradermal vaccine after its approval in August 2022. The results demonstrated that the intradermal dose-saving vaccination route is preferable to the subcutaneous route and that patients in the low CD4 group may require at least one booster to generate an efficient response of specific T-cells from Mpox. Wrote the authors, this study has two relevant points, study author Robert Gary Fernandez, MD, PhD, head of infectious diseases at the Hospital del Mar Medical Research Institute, told the Medscape Spanish edition. In the subgroup of patients with HIV with effective treatment but without an immune response, i.e., low CD4, the vaccine response is worse than in people who have recovered immunity or do not have HIV. Therefore, they need a booster dose. The second point is that the intradermal route with 1/5 of the standard subcutaneous dose has a better immune response than the standard subcutaneous route. He added that it was a good strategy to save doses and be able to vaccinate many more people when vaccine shortages occurred. A general conclusion cannot be drawn, he added. It needs to be validated with many more subjects, of course, but in some way, it reinforced our confidence in the strategy of health authorities to promote intradermal vaccination. There we had evidence that the patients we were vaccinating intradermally were responding well. In Spain, although there is no shortage of vaccines today, they continue to be administered intradermally with a fractionated dose equivalent to 1/5 of a standard dose, said Gary Fernandez. However, in his opinion, observations regarding the two administration routes signal a need for further research. The main message should be that for patients with HIV infection who do not have an immune response, the vaccine response is incomplete, and they need booster doses as well as monitoring of the vaccine immune response, said Gary Fernandez. More studies required. The research, which prospectively collected data and blood samples from patients with HIV who received the JYNNEOS vaccine, is small and included only 24 patients with HIV infection, with 7 hospital workers who also received the vaccine and 7 unvaccinated individuals as controls. I am one of the control subjects of the study, and intradermal vaccination is not especially pleasant, commented Gary Fernandez. It is a very innervated area, and the moment of introducing the liquid is uncomfortable. But it is perfectly bearable. Outpatient HIV-infected patients from the Infectious Diseases Unit of Hospital Del Mar on antiretroviral therapy and with undetectable viral loads were grouped according to their CD4 T lymphocyte counts. Those with CD4 T lymphocyte counts less than or equal to 500/mm3 required at least one booster vaccine to exhibit efficient virus-specific T lymphocyte responses. Garcia emphasized that the most novel aspect is that the JYNNEOS vaccine induces a specific T-cell response in patients with HIV infection that increases with higher CD4 T lymphocyte levels. However, he noted that the number of patients was less than 10 in most study groups, and the control group had only intradermal administration, which limits the interpretation of the results. It will be necessary to verify this in studies with larger groups with control groups from all routes and with a correlative protection. Garcia referred to this latter point as a significant source of uncertainty. The study is fundamentally based on the cellular response, but nowadays, there is no immune correlate of real-life protection. He concluded that the study builds knowledge, which is essential for a vaccine that began to be used from Mpox and the effectiveness of which is based on estimates.